Hi all, and welcome to the video. It's the fr00b playthrough number 4, and we're going to attempt to try and help the fr00b new person community. Right, so we don't really want to spend too much time in here. However, we do want to get things moving, so let's talk to Rex Larson. And it doesn't really matter what we say to him, but he'll still give you the mission anyway, so get to the point, Rex. Okay, and he'll give you a mission, and all it is literally kill a bunch of these, and when you've finished, click on there, and that's it. Right. So let's get to it. Now, something I didn't mention for the new people is if it's a solar-powered weapon, it doesn't actually need any ammo. There you go. I've completed the mission. Now, before we go any further, I'm just going to kill a bunch more of these. Oop. Malfunctioning cleaning we want. Okay, so that's a ding. We run out already. We may have done. Malfunctioning, no, that's what we want. So we might as well kill a few of these till they're green on us. You can see we're not really struggling to get it done. We did ding, so let's do a bit here. I'm maxing base abilities between now and, well, probably a fair bit longer, actually. The main reason is implants, but I am going to range, dodge range and evade close, and then I'm going to leave the rest just for now. Again, energy, ranged in it, range specials. Now in the casting, we'll get to this in a minute. I'm going to show you a neat sort of thing you need to do if you've got a fixer and you don't know about this. Okay. Treatment, yeah, and first aid. Complete. Save. Clears. Now, something not often discussed is the AgDef bar here. When it's all the way over to death, you can see by the action bar how much slower we actually are, and that's based on the init you have. Now if I move that back all the way across, you can see it's almost twice as fast. Now the more ranged init we have, and the relative speed of the weapon, the quicker we can actually shoot. And if we can shoot more often, then we basically do more damage. So the ideal weapon that you really want there is to be able to have this all the way over here, which makes you hard to hit, and enough init, etc., for the weapon itself to be firing as fast as it possibly can. So we'll carry on, seeing as we've still got a few of these. Now, if you're interested in the clan shoulder pads, or the Omni shoulder pads, I'll take that. Trash. These guys actually drop a lot of the parts you need for it right here. So it's actually... Oh, hang on. I want a tiny sword. I'll take the NCU as well. Have I missed any here? I'll just take the junk. Because we can vendor all this. Vendors seem to have an infinite amount of... credits, so they never run out when you're buying and selling from them. And you see, as we're doing this, we're actually getting a few creds from each one. Suppose, in theory, you could stay here long enough to make a stack of money, but I wouldn't advise it. There's much better ways. Okay, I might get one more level out of these guys. They don't seem to be dropping the parts I want for the clad shoulder pads, though. You'll know what they are. They've got a blue name. It's got a blue name. Pay attention. Ah, there we go. Liquid bass conductors. They're part of it. You get a bunch of pretty random sounding items, and they all assemble. I'll show you how when we get there, because I'll probably actually do the doctor quest on this guy. Although whether I can actually finish it without some help, I don't know. Because killing off the Trash King, etc., even on a fixer was hard back in the day, and it's going to be hard now, because we're fr00b. I don't think anything's actually hit us yet. Okay, while we wait for the next spawn, let's spend that other bit of IP again. You notice I'm not touching these yet. You'll see why in a minute. Run speed. Complete. And combat and healing. Actually, we'll just keep raising treatment. Trade and repair. Max. Right. Okay. So when we get through this wave, we're probably not going to get any more XP, or only get one XP. Oh no, that one's still green. Looks like we're here for this wave. Now, as you saw, when I'm increasing that SMG skill, if I click on this symbol here, I'll close down my wear window, you can see there, attack rating 30. So that's 30 because I've got that much. You're not allowed to... That's a bug. No one else up here killing that I can see, at least. Ooh, a ring. Add projectile damage. Take that. We'll take that. So this is probably boring for veterans, but don't worry about it. We might as well do a bit of mopping up in here, because, I mean, the last thing you do is want to wander out of here without the all the free gear that it actually has to offer. Yeah, that would be a bit of a mistake. And if you want to know the full quest walkthrough, it's a treatment ring. Not a very high one, I grant you, but then, yep, that's already there. Link in the corner. Let's do a bit more looting up. Aha! There we go. Another part of the Doctor Quest stuff. Junk. Useful junk. Allowed to remove those remains. Ah, there we go. Strange one, that. There we go. Newt Newbie OCC. Hobbs and Newbliz. A House of Black Star is recruiting mature, active, 24/7, large PBM org since 2000. Are they? Have they been going that long? Maybe they have. Yeah. What you'll find is the larger... or successful orgs generally aren't spamming the startup area noob channels. But, you know, maybe a few are. But if you are a complete noob, why not? Great way to learn. Who knows, make some friends along the way. Okay, I'm pretty sure they should be grey after this one. Yep, they're grey. So that's us done with those. Okay, let's talk to Rex. You receive a bunch of XP. I've done what you asked. Can you tell me who your contact is? Okay. Goodbye. Right, okay, so, once again, and raise these. We'll need them for implants later. And yes, you definitely want implants. You don't need multi-ranged yet. Put it that way. Okay. Burst. Did I do init? I did. Still leaving that. Don't worry, we are getting to it. Run speed. All right, healing. Just keep going with treatment. We'll leave first aid where it is, because if you actually read, if you've been away a while or you're new, right, Stimpak. There you go. First aid skill locked for 40 seconds. We don't need more, because it only needs first aid for 11. Now, if you look at these, health and nano recharger, it says here, first aid from 7 or treatment from 7. So that works with either. And that doesn't, but you need the treatment for your implants. Trade and repair. Already getting close to 61 complaint. And yeah, nothing there. Right, if you go... Oh, they moved it. Used to be a shop right here. And apparently you can get down from here by jumping up on these boxes. I have done it when I've been in a hurry to get a brand new character out. Okay, we'll just heal up. Right, Marcus Stone. He's going to ask us to do something. And it's pretty simple, although it's not well explained. Goodbye. So he's asked you to do something. And if you open your inventory, you'll find you have got a compact fire suppressant container. And basically, you pick this up with the mouse by left-clicking it, and then right-click it on a fire. Mission done. He won't talk to you while he's fighting this thing. So now he's not fighting it, we can talk to him. Thanks. Now, don't just run off yet. There's a bit more to do. One. Oop, let's move our inventory over a bit. Another thing to do, apart from hand him that back, that's the first part of your get me out of here card. So, tell him thanks again. And then just ask him, are the wounded workers your guys? Agree to do the mission? Say goodbye. Okay, now, another item spawned in your inventory, but this one works differently, which I think is a bit counterintuitive for new people, but instead of doing this, picking it up with a left click and right clicking on the target, which is a wounded dot worker, you actually target the wounded dot worker and right click it inside your inventory. Yeah. See, it doesn't seem to be a fixed way of doing things in Anarchy Online, but there we go. Marcus Stone. I healed one of your guys, and he asks for this back. You can't use it on yourself anyway, so there we go. And he gives us these. Now, you can combine them with the ones you've already got by picking them up with the left mouse. Oop. Well, usually you can. Yeah, there you go. And dropping them on the ones you've already got. There you go. I've now got 49 first aids and 100 recharges. Tell him he's welcome. Right, next bit is, again, very easily, and I have covered this in a previous video. Yeah, everything's grey here. Now, you might be thinking about this weapon and thinking, it's a bit rubbish. And the truth is, yeah, it is a bit rubbish. I mean, look. DPS, 9. Yeah, not brilliant. But, not to worry, we can upgrade it, and I'll be showing you how in this episode. So I'm trying to be as frub friendly as I can be in here. Now, this is the next guy we want to talk to. You'll notice he has a blue name. If anything has a blue name, it's involved with quests, missions and such, usually. Okay, wants the hardware. You don't... Well, if you want to find out what it is, you can. Again, that's explained in previous videos. So, I want to say, what do they want with it? And then what is... And goodbye. Now, this might trip you up. Now, I'm going to click on, see the M button here? I'm going to click on that. And that will normally not be attached over here. So I'm going to move that over here. And it says, find bioanalyzing.com. So, find a bioanalyzing computer. At the request of Flint Novak, you must find a bioanalyzing computer. You may find one of these computers by taking out the malfunctioning robots in the nearby junk barn. Mission objective, kill 7. So... You can kill them, and you don't even need to loot them to do this. But let's try and find some that are worthwhile killing. In other words, not grey ones. We nip through here. Garbage fleas, by the way, are aggressive, and they will attack you. So you can kill 3 of any mechanoid type mob, and it will complete the mission. We may as well nip over here. There we go. Strangely, that garbage flea hasn't aggroed us. It may be grey. It is. That's why it hasn't aggroed. Docker. And we'll hit that one as well. And there's a few items these drop, which we're going to need to upgrade these weapons. Have I misread that mission? Malfunctioning droids. Okay. I think they do need to be malfunctioning. Okay. Take that. I think we need one of those. Garbage flea. Just being annoying. It's kind of the new roller app. So it says malfunctioning, so we may have to just nip that and hit malfunctioning things. Come on, we can make that. Yeah. This guy counts. He's one of the first bosses. You notice he's got like a bit of a shield on him. That blue glow that's semi-displaced there. I better use the first aid. There we go. Just die. Come on. There we go. Now he will drop a bunch of junk. Instruction disc, you need those to make nanos. We don't really need that one because we couldn't make it anyway. Pilgrim armor protected, yeah, kind of. Mostly, this is junk, but pick it up to sell it afterwards. I'm going to leave it on the corpse. Deliver the bioanalyst. Oh, I was counting those guys. I couldn't see an update in the spam window. So, no biggie. Now, we need to hand that in to this NPC here, Alex Gibbs. There, we just hand this over, drop it in the window, press the tick button, and she gives us an item. Now, I know what to do with this already because I've done this once or twice. So, okay. Surveillance uplink. Mission objective. Target the surveillance droid and use and right click. So, that's the first part. Anything on these guys? Usually not. We're going to need to talk to him again in a second. Now, if you run down here, you'll find the cleaning bot you actually need to speak to. And he's floating in the air just here. Alright. Pick this up. Drop it on him. Looks like it's working. Or is it? So let's right-click it from the inventory then. Yep, it's usually one or the other. Now, that's produced a new item, and it wants us to put it somewhere, and I'll show you exactly where you need to put it. So you run up into this small building here, head towards this plant. See, the plant is just so, and there it is. So that's that part of the mission completed. While you're here, though, talk to this guy. Just ask him for any work. And he'll ask you to go fetch a burger. Now, as we're running back to get the burger, we've also got to deliver the first item we got to the guy we passed just a little bit earlier. And we give him this, click OK. More XP. Tell him, okay, we'll take care of it. And that's it. He doesn't want to talk to you again. Now, talk to Barry the food vendor and just press the thing there. Now, I like having the trade window separate. You may want to keep it over there. And we're looking for a type of burger with a blue name. Bronto Burger. And we'll say, yes, we've got enough creds. We've got about 5,000 already. We'll tell him goodbye. Right, if we run back to Galitri, I'll ask us to do two more jobs, and they involve being not very nice to these chaps, the protesters. So if you're into your role-playing stuff, you might not like this mission, but it does give you the opportunity to get some clothes, which do have some stat boosting on them. Right, Desmond Kalitri, I have your Bronto Burger. There we go, we hand him that. What do you need help with? Okay, so next one he gives. Rally against the machine. Number of Desmond's dock workers have grown tired of his conditions they work under. They've begun to organise to demonstrate their dislike of the current state of affairs. Desmond has asked you to silence some of these individuals. Basically, tab Q, two of these guys. They can barely hit. There's another one there, so let's give him a bit of SMG love as well. Job done. I talked to him again. I took care of them. He'll now ask me us to take care of the ringleader. Just go. You can see they bounce back to health relatively quickly. Now, a lot of the reason I did the leveling up at the top plane is the mission rewards for this would make you ding every single time. In other words, you'd level. So burst is effective. Junk. Oh, right. It's already telling me. Inventory full. Please make room in your inventory. So, okay, we're going to do that. And we're going to do that by opening our backpack and putting a bunch of junk in it. And we're doing that so we can sell it later. Eventually. Right, so it's given us three basic armors. Again, I've covered this in a previous video, but there we go. You've got some ACs there, and you can see adds XP, gives you max nano and max health. This rather stylish one adds to your offensive stat, and this one adds to nano cost. We're going for this one because it actually looks quite cool. Can I just put it on, or is it going to give me hard time? Please make... Yeah, right, okay. I think I have to take the bag off to get it to come off. So, I'm going to have to take off the bag. And there we go. We look a little more swish around town. And that's kind of it. He won't bother talking to you again. So, it's now saying kneecapping a knee breaker. Now, this guy is up here. So, we're going to do this one. Because what we want to get to pretty quickly, you'll be coming back here to this shipping manifest terminal. But before we do that, you want to nip in here and have a word with this guy. And by having a word, yeah, I'm in kill. There we go. You now see our attack rating is at 46. He doesn't really drop anything at any time, apart from creds. But 23 credits ain't going to get you very far in Anarchy Online. Right, while we're here, let's do a quick bit of IP again. Now, the only thing with the packs is you have to sit down momentarily. No, didn't make the jump yet. Right, so we return. Report to Alex. Talk to Alex again. They will give you some trade skill missions, which are actually quite useful. But we don't need them. Can you... Oh, I've clicked on it. Never mind. Let's just not highlight that one. Let's upload to map. And now that one isn't there. It basically just tells you to use a screwdriver on there. We can do it if you want, but you need to get the screwdriver. Now, it doesn't look like it, but that is a shop. So we want a screwdriver. And we want one of those, and I'll show you why in a moment. And we're going to need that as well. Is that everything I need just for now? I think it is. So that's 2k gone, but there is a reason for that. So we use this on here. We complete that mission, and then we add this to the second item, or vice versa. Have I run out of room? Let's have a look. Trade skilling. Oh, one more item. That one. Okay. And then we add that to there. Or that to there. There we go. Increases sense, sits on his shoulder. You make those up to quality 200. I think they, at that point they actually add a little bit more. Now it wants us to go to Stan Goodman. This thing here is called an overflow window. If your inventory is full and you create an item, then that's where it'll end up. Now we've picked up another nano, which is kind of a trade skill kind of stuff, but useful nonetheless. I'll upload it just so it's not in my inventory. Ah, hang on. Your sensory improvement and modification is required to be at least 20. Okay, well, I'll leave it for now and I'll show you why in a second. Right, as we're running past this guy, let's talk to Patrick's son, who will kill you. But don't worry, you don't actually lose XP until you're over a certain level in AO. So let's get it over with so we can get our 3-slot belt. Click on the insurance terminal. Talk to Patrick again, and he will kill us. I've used the cell scanner and it, yep, punches you to death. Watch the damage. He hit you for 82,715 points of melee damage. And given we've got 217 points of HP, that's quite a bit. And talk to him again though. Tell him he's evil. And when he catches up, there you go. You owe me big time. I'm going to report you to the guards. And, yeah, you get XP. And a belt. I don't think we can wear it yet, though. We need complete 76. We have 66. 70. Yeah, not far off. We'll just finish off on these. Right, still can't wear it, but yeah, just quickly do that. Now, before we get all the way to Stan, we're going to go and talk to this chap. How do you pronounce it? Antonio Stacklund. And I've also got a guide for this. I'd like to upgrade my weapon. Now, you need to tell him what type of weapon you've got, and the type of weapon we've got is a SMG, submachine gun. Tell him that, and he will literally give you a mini mission to fix it. So it tells us we need to get bone plates and one of his devices, combine them, which gives us this, and then we use that item to upgrade that to a silent one. As you can see there, gives us a bit more damage. Now, another item we want from him, we can probably have to say goodbye to get out of it, is we want a couple of other things. If you ask him, do you only have weapons and upgrades? You say, teach me how to make a bracer. You're going to be making two of them. And then you need to ask him, do you only sell weapons and bracers? And you want to make a HUD device. The vest, you're not going to need because you are going to be making your sided armor, which is a lot better. Unfortunately, because we're Froob, we can't talk to Remy. And Remy can't give us our ginormous rocket launcher, which, yes, I've already done a video for. Now then, Stuckland we want, and then we need to do a little bit of killing. Oh, you can talk to this lady. You've got two choices here. Now, it doesn't really matter what you say to her, but she's going to mention that she's lost her credit card, and it's actually right underneath us. If you look through the grill here, you see that shiny thing? If I move, that little blue thing there, that's the credit card. Now, if you pick it up and keep it, you'll get 15k. If you give it to her, you'll get a med suit. So make your choice. I'm probably going to keep the caps, because med suits are not something I struggle for, and that's because I have other characters with bags of them. But if you're new, I would probably recommend getting the med suit, in fact. So anyway, he's going to give us a mission to get stuff. I suppose I don't have much choice. So okay, we'll say goodbye there. Now, we've now got lots of stuff on here, and it's telling me to buy a lockpick. So, what it doesn't tell you is where to get it. Or does it now? It didn't in the beta. So, upload to map. Oh, yeah, it's giving us a bit of a clue. Always a good thing. Everyone likes it when you actually got a clue. I think we need to nip in here. Buy a lockpick. Now, I'm going to buy a lockpick and a hacking device. I'll show you why in a minute. So we get those. Right click. Oh, NCU space. Not to worry. So we'll put the other outfits we're not wearing in here. Right, now right click and boom, got a lockpick. Now, the reason I got this is, I think it's these two. Can't remember now. It's nano programming interface and hacker tool, I thought. May not be. Is it lockpick? Ah, need 25 in nano programming. But to get 25, I need at least 20 in psycho mod. Complicated, isn't it? Right, so. Psycho mod. 20. And sense imp. 20. So the only two I'm going to raise just now. Now, if I do this. Okay. Cast it on myself. Now, if I try and use the lockpick on here. Or is it the hacking device? You need 60 in breaking and entering. Thanks for letting me know all in one go. All right, breaking and entering, we can get to 73, so we will. And now that's turned into this NCU hacker device. Now, if you're a fixer, you absolutely want to make one of these. And you're going, well, it's only given me one. Yeah, click it, and you'll see there's now a quality 4, and it will keep doing that all the way through your levels. Up to level 220, in fact, which will give you quite a bit more in nano skill. But for now, it's just there. If you go to your utilities hub, where the hell does this go anyway? Have I clicked it too far? Level from 8. No, that's right. There you go. Comes in HUD 1. Very useful, especially if you're frube. So we'll save that and close. Close our backpack, and then we've bought the lockpick, and it says take the contents of the strongbox. We're not ready to talk to this guy yet, though we will be very shortly. So, the strongbox is in this room over here. There's a catch. There's a guard dog in it, but it has almost no perception. If you get up close to the door and use sneak, if you're not sure, no problem. Oh, it's attacking us. And it's run back off. Now, sneaking is H. Well, actually, I'm going to change that to V just for now. Okay, so let's hit V. And you can see everything has detected you. My chat settings haven't stuck because all that should be in there. So we'll sort that. Now, as soon as we lockpick, the dog will probably see us. So we're going to... There we go. And that gives us one of these. But we're going to need a couple more to make the bits we need to make. Now, don't think the dog follows us too far anymore. And if it does, literally just run over to some guards who will promptly destroy it for you. Right, so we pop back to Stanley. I have what you were looking for. Now, he wants 4 items back. And the items he wants are the one you just looted, as well as these items, which are the ones you've amassed so far. We give him all 4. There we go, and we get the XP. You can say roleplay it any way you like. And he just says, watch your back. So, now, buy some nano programs. Well, we've got 8k. Now, I've got access to med suits and the like, so I'm not too worried about getting one from in here. But where I'm getting them from may cause a bit of a problem, because there's plenty of mobs down there that are going to do us harm. However, if you remember, we were talking to the trade skilling. Remember, we needed plates and a poison injector. We needed a venom sample. The venom samples actually drop from the fleas. So we're going to kill our way down to the credit card. Probably someone else farming for them down here. Not too worried about that. That will fight us, but it doesn't mean we can't angle it so we can... Despite it being a pain. There we go, we've picked it. I'm going to right click it and steal the money. You can see there, I'm on full death. Now, the reason I'm on full death is so they can't hurt me. Now, did the flea actually drop anything I want? No. We want the samples. Now, let's just check our chat configuration. You see, we've got all this garbage has put itself back in here. Oh, do want vicinity. And my pets, if I actually had any. Spam should have all that stuff. Research system, team loot, tower battle, vicinity, your pets. We'll put that in there. Go back to this one. Say hi, channel subscribed. Just make sure we haven't got anything we don't want. We'll leave it as that, and then spam should have all the combat and all that. Right, okay. That should do it. Right, so we can come off full death now, because while on it meant we were very difficult to hit. You didn't know that already, and I can hear all the veterans going, oh, for God's sake, we know this stuff. Oh, I'll wear the ring as well. Now, not only do we need those for that, you can see... Oh, we don't need them for that. But we want to make two braces. Did he give us that? Did I not get the braces one? Yeah, the braces are good. They change your damage. You're not allowed to loot these remains. They change your damage to poison. Now, poison AC, you can see here the things are actually split up. I'll have a go with him. Oh, we haven't got the mission yet, have we? So, okay, he's going to give us some grief. Not too worried. So rather than go all the way deaf, we'll just go a little way deaf. They're looting a bunch of junk, so good luck to them. I'm probably just selling it. An easy way to make a ton of money in here. I'm sure you've probably figured it out by now. Do I want to join Bopulus's team? Not really. I'd say no. No harm in talking to people, even if you don't necessarily want to be in the team with them. See, because what would happen then is I'd feel kind of obliged, as I am, to talk to them. And that wouldn't be a problem, but I'm trying to speak as I'm playing. So speaking and playing, doable. Speaking, playing, and talking to another person, I'll probably struggle with that just a little bit. So yeah. Now, things are going to get a lot easier once I've done this guy. I probably didn't need to kill anyway, but I just want to. Alright, so that's him out of the way. Hilton, don't really need any of this stuff. It is just junk. I'll just loot as much as I can and then go sell it. Not worth a lot, but they probably looted everything from there, have they? Yeah. All I want are the venom samples, and that is to make the bracers. Now you'll see what they do. They actually change your damage type to poison, and as I was saying, when you look here, I expand this slightly. No, is that max? So you've got melee, impact, energy, disease. It's usually quite a low stat on a lot of mobs. So it's a good one to take advantage of. Let me just try this guy. Yeah, our weapon's starting to seem a bit more rubbish. If you remember when we were up at the very start, we were pretty much one shot, one kill. And these mobs are green, and we're sort of struggling to do much damage to them. So, we need to fix up our weapon. And that's going to cost us a couple of creds. But we've now got 15k, so it's not that big a problem. Now, can I get over? Yeah. You is a shorter way round. Okay, so it wants us to talk to this lady here. Now then, she sells two types of armour. However, she also gives you part of the main quest. What do you have for sale? Right, there we go. So, now you can see here you've got newcomer's armour. And you think, oh, 10 ACs, what else have we got? And then you look here and go, right, okay. Ooh, Sundance gloves, they've got extra stats. Don't buy them. Tell you why, because they don't level. And by that, I mean with these, when you buy them and click them, they upgrade themselves. Which means that you're getting armour that you can carry on using till you're 220 in theory. Although, most likely you won't, but if you're prune, you might not have a massive amount of choice. Although, if I make this guy GA fixer, which I'll explain later, then that might be a bit of a thing. So we've got top pants we want on, two sleeves, pair of boots, pair of gloves. Make sure we've got the right ones. Newcomers. And if we expand this window, and you can, we can double check everything we bought before clicking. So we've got newcomer body armor, newcomer gloves, newcomer pants, newcomer sleeves twice, and that. And there's no newcomer's helmet, unfortunately. There's these sort of things. Sundance headband. Kind of okay. And then etchers if you want to make carbonium armor. But that doesn't level. Now then, as we're selling that to her, let's see if we can get it down to zero just by putting a stack of junk into our end of the deal. Okay, so we don't need any of these. Literally. Because this armour is definitely better in that you don't have to keep buying new armour all the time when you first start, which can be expensive. You can't sell this stuff because it's no drop. And the kid, they're pretty awful. Shadow filter, don't need. Treatment one, not going to need that. That sold quite well though, didn't it? And pants, don't need. Tiny sword, I think is no drop. It is. Okay, and we say goodbye, click accept, and we've actually made money on the deal and got this armour. You can see there, that's level one. If I right click, it's now level two. And keep going, and it will dance around in your inventory, which is a bit annoying, but if you make space right next to each other, it's okay. So there you go, it's level 8, same level as us, and it gives us all those ACs versus the ones we could have bought from the Sundance, and we haven't even clanalized it yet. So, find the thief, well, we did that, and that's going to take seconds to repeat, and while we're down there, we'll kill a few more of those guys. When we get back up, we should have plenty of creds, God, I've been playing Fallout too much. Tiny sword again. We'll take the other NCU, though. It's the other side we want for that guy. No, you can't keep picking credit cards up unless you keep making new characters. Which, you know, is a thing you could do. Now, as soon as you buy the nano programs, one of them's called a heal over time. And what the heal over time does is exactly what it sounds like. It keeps healing you. And that's for quite a long time these days. They only used to last sort of 20 minutes or so. Oh god, go away! I don't want your help. You'll kill steal off me. There's one. Now you see, they vanish. I don't get the loot. because he ran down and interfered. Although, if I'd have been in a lot of trouble, I'd have been pretty glad to see him, I guess. Now, I'm not going to kill that thing a second time, because I don't need any stuff from it to sell. You see this? Garbage flea tried to hit you, but missed. Now, it's using melee damage against us, which means, if you look at your defense, it's this one, evade, closer, which means evade close combat. Essentially, it's all melee damage. Right, so can't see any regular fleas. And all I want to do is click on the corpse here. That'll do nicely. And then bravely run away. And you'll see it drops armor in here and you think, oh my god, I should wear this immediately. You can't wear it. You can't. There you go. This is a experimental set of armor. It is as impressive visually as it is functionally. This particular set, however, seems to be already DNA locked. In other words, sorry, can't wear it. Because that meant the ACs in here would be vastly overpowered, and you know it. Can we loot that one? Oh yeah, tiny sword. We're going to need a few more of these, but let's crack on. Where did you get? Oh, you ran from there. Did wonder how he'd gotten down. Right, okay. Now, we need to visit Stutland, because you look, assemble a stabilised. We need one. That's going to upgrade the weapon. Assemble a poison injector and eventually get to a brazier. We're going to need, well, four for each. Two for each, so four of those. So we need one, five, and a range meter, two more. So we need seven. My God. Need seven of these damn things. Have I got seven slots in my inventory? Plus the parts I'm going to need. I probably don't, actually. I probably don't. So what I should do is start wearing my armour. Okay, and to put it on, you do need to pick it up. Got to close. Pop it on there. Now, because I've got this in my back armour, it means I don't have to look like I'm wearing that. I just look like I'm wearing that back armour. But that's not going to last for long on a fixer, because we've got much better things to put in our back armour. Let's just click these. Oh, I bought sundown boots. What a noob. Get those on. Oh, I'm going to have to come and sell those back. But when you sell things back, no, you do not get the price you paid for them, unfortunately. Something I learned very early on in this game. The other thing I should have learned was read. We look, I bet it says must have expansion set Shadowlands and level 6. So yeah, put these on. So because we're buying off him, we might as well do that. Now then, he has got spare weapons, so if you want a dual wield, you can buy your second weapon from here. We don't need to. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. God, 7 of the damn things. Right, you can have those. NCUs. Well, we're going to pick up. Well, mind you, no. We may need these, actually. May need these. A bit later. You'll see why. Right. Let's accept that. Right, we've got those. And tell him goodbye. So we've got the stuff we need from him and the missions to remind us how to make them. Right, let's go talk to this lady again, Sarah Green. Didn't you used to be on Blue Peter? Okay, we found the stolen armour. And we hand it back. Click OK, which gives us another device. We'll just say thanks. Now she does, if you ask her anyone else I should talk to, she'll send you over to Remy with the rocket launcher. However, we can't talk to Remy because we don't have alien invasion. Now then, as you can see here, speak to Vernon Godfrey. We speak to Vernon. He's not very friendly. Pill-sized object with an electromagnetic connector poking with the sides. Basically, he wants you to hack something. He waits for you to follow instructions. Fine, I will hold the items for you. And then he wants you to hack them. And to hack them, we go and get our hacking item. Oh, he's given us one. Oh, I didn't need to buy it. Never mind. So there we go, we're hacked. Say I'm done now. I was able to hack the device. Pass it back. Click on there. Right. Any questions? Just say no. It won't make any difference. You've still got to do it anyway. Right. So, before we crack on with that, we need to go and buy some nano programs. And then this is why I may need that thing. I don't need the trade skill anymore. So, I'll just right-click it, and that's gone. Right, we talked to this guy, and he sells a pack, and this is not how you normally buy them. You ask him, he'll explain it to you. We don't need that. Now, we want fixer ones. Don't buy agent ones. You won't be able to use them if you're a fixer, and if you buy fixer ones and you're an agent, again, you won't be able to use them. So we buy this for elite credits. Click accept. Tell him goodbye. Now, normally, you have to buy them in shop, so that gives us general abilities, but it's saying here, your cycle mod, blah, 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 needs to be. And this one needs to be. So what it's telling you straight away is which nano skills you need to raise. So if I just grab this and try and set this over, you can see I also got two here. I'm not panicking. I will make room for them. I don't need two hacking devices, so I'm going to delete it. Grab one back. I think that's a root, is it? Yeah, it's a snare. right, okay. Have I got any more room in this backpack? Yes, I do. Let's put some other bits in here that we don't need just yet. Three slots. The hacking device. Close that and open that. If you accidentally close the overflow, don't panic. Just force your inventory to overflow again. It will reappear. Right, so, as you can see here, it's telling us straight over. Oh, yeah, never mind. Matter met is required to be 57. Right, we apparently need that. So, nano and casting, matter met. Ooh, 51, not far off. Your biomet needs to be 43. Now, this is for the heal, so we're not too far away. Your time space is required to be 43. We can probably do the time space. Yep. And don't forget, take this out and give it a click or two. You are going to get a couple of points more. Not enough this time, though. Yeah, it's still only giving us three at this level. Right, okay, can we get any of the others? Yeah, so now this one. Self only, I think. It might not be anymore. And I don't think we're going to get this one, are we? Matter met from 57. No, we're not. See, try and upload it and it keeps saying check the requirements. Snare? No. Can we do this one, though? Sense imp. Aha. Uh-huh. Okay, so sense imp needs to be 30. And psycho mod also needs to be 30. Save. Now that one increases our, you guessed it, base stats, which also boosts these, but not quite enough. So anyway, that's that portion of that over, and that's kind of how nano skills work. Also, when you click on them, take a look. If I click on matter met, it's telling me how much it's costing to improve. And the further up it goes, the more it costs, believe it or not. But you can see here, dependencies, intelligence and psychic. If we go to matter met, intelligence, psychic, time space, intelligence and agility. Pretty much every nano skill needs intelligence, which is why we go back to base abilities. I have been raising it, so let's hopefully be able to max the rest. Well, why are you raising these two, strength and stamina? They bleed into some weapon skills, and also stamina dictates how much health you've got because it bleeds into body dev. Now, I should just about have enough IP for the way I've been spending it. I've been sort of guesstimating the top of my head how much I'm spending. And you can see there, let me just show you something. So burst at 48, cost to improve 43. Now, if I try and do the same with aim shot, and see that cost to improve 12 until I try and take it all the way up there. And you can see, as I'm clicking, it's costing a damn sight more improvement points, or IP. So there you go. To get that to 54, don't forget I've got buffs running and stuff. So yeah, it actually costs more, believe it or not. But that was it. Oh, did we do run speed? Hopefully we did run speed, and nope, we didn't. We don't need more breaking and entry just yet. Do these. Might as well do that. We've got a bit spare from what we were planning to make. Trade and repair. And you probably see that. That's already done. Did we do exploring? No. There we go. Fixers. Have some damn fast run speed. Now, let's take a quick look here. It's not the one. Right, poison injector. So, first off, we need to use the venom sample and one of Antonio's devices. I'm going to pick that up and use it. We get that. We now need a second item. Now, those drop from mechanoid-type mobs. Now, I know where we can find mechanoids and garbage fleas at the same time. So, that should speed up the process. We're going to do that. Beef our character up a little bit. Now, if you get to this fence, there's a sneaky way through in this corner. See here? Yep, nearly. There we go. That's better. So we just now need to kill lots of these guys. I don't think this boss actually drops them. I say boss. You know, diner. Anything? No. We'll try him anyway. Actually, we'll take a chance and go a bit more full ag. See how much he hits us. He's still missing us a bit, but he's got a damage shield. It's not too bad. Ooh, can we use that one? Oh, we can use that one. So let's buff ourselves with that. That's a hot. Basic insurance hack. I'll cast that. You can see that little red symbol there. That's a short heal. In other words, that only runs, you can see there, for a short amount of time. But it is helping, because it's healing us. Now the long one we do want to use, which is... Where's that gone? There. Yeah, we can't upload that yet, which is a shame. Got it. Already got that. You can see what I mean, this stuff really is kind of junk. Right, let's just recharge nano and such. Right, garbage flea. The bone plates, etc., are going to take a bit more getting. So the ones for there, bone plates, they drop from a large cleaner. So we're going to have to kill mini balls, basically, to get those. Let's see if we can get the other item we need to make the first poison injector, which is... What's it actually called? Compression chamber, which do drop from these guys. Do we need that fluid sample for anything? Range meter? No, don't need it. It's be used to upgrade a different weapon. So yeah, it's going to be boring for a minute while I do it. Maybe you've gone. Where did he... is that his corpse there? No. It just vanished. That does happen. And it's damn annoying when it's a boss. Got to remember the amount of times eel used to disappear into the ground back in the day. Right. Docker. Attack. Flea will attack you while we're looting. Power supply. I think we need that, don't we? Was it power supply we need for anything? Yes, we do. So we'll use this on that. Yeah, we're going to need it later. That's a false corpse in the floor there. You can't actually pick it up, which is annoying. Don't need two of them, do we? That's just the range meter. Yeah, don't need it for that. But we can use one on there. Now, if I get that plus that and combine this with that... Da-da-da! Range meter. Now, you can see that's giving me ranged grenades. It wouldn't matter which weapon type or nano I was using to do that, but it also adds a bunch of damage. Only three, I admit. It's not much, and that goes in HUD 3, I think. Yeah, HUD 3 only. As we're through, but it's damn useful. Right. Compression chamber. Come on. I need two of them. Nope. It's a bit unfortunate the way they die. The posterior stuck in the air. don't need it. Oh, look. It's getting sunnier. Ooh, what we got? Defensive ring. Taking that. Not worth a lot, but go to your clothes. Pop that on. This gives you a lot, tiny bit more defense. Always useful. There's a guy there. He's a keeper, judging by that weapon. And now people are going to try and fight. Ah! Over loot, no doubt. Okay. So that's that done. Combined with this. Gives us bracer number one. And we're going to need more of those. Right. Let me just keep going. We probably will end up fighting over loot. Although, if they're making the bracers, we're definitely going to be fighting over loot. How much flea? Well, they could just be going a very slow way at farming creds. Yes, you could sell all those, but remember when we picked up the credit card and we got 15k? Yeah, well, the thing with that, you see, is you could, you know, because it's a fr00b account. I'm not saying you should do this, but you could roll a secondary one and go loot it again, delete that character, roll another one, delete that character. Add infinite. You'd probably stay in here till you've got a million credits. It'd probably take a very long time to do it, though. You'd probably make a million credits a damn sight quicker when once you get out than you would in there. Hey, compression chamber. We need that. Now we just need another one of those venom samples, I think. Or do we? Do we need something else? Oh, we've lost the mission there, so I can't see what it was. Power supply. No, don't need that. That was for the HUD item. I think it is just fleas, but let's just check. Do I need that? I think it... What the... Oh, God. Now I can't remember what I used it for. Optical enhancer. No, it's venom sample I want. It's venom sample. Suppose we could run back to where the fleas are, because we're going to have to go that way and kill mini balls as much as we can. They're a bit tougher, by the way, to get the bone plates from them. Once you get the bone plates, is it 2-stage upgrade or just one? Let's take a look. No, it is just one, so I need one for the bracer and I need one. Yeah, that's the upgraded compression table. So I need one for the bracer and one for the weapon. So let's just nip down here. Garbage fleet. Ooh, green one. Awesome. Actually get XP for these. Nope. Nothing on you. What about your friend over here? That's handy. And... so there's another defensive ring. Right, okay, so we do that. We get that. Combine it with that. Oh, there we go. And that's two braces. So we've now got poison damage 3, damage override type, temp set to poison. So while you're wearing them, you do poison damage. So you've got 3, plus 3, plus 3. Just from those. Ooh, we're a little damage-dealing monster now. Well, a bit. Right, now we've done that, I'm going to run to where I know the mini bulls are, which is kind of east. Cargo lifting. Oh yeah, we'll get back to that. Let's do the weaponed stuff first. We should be able to handle mini bulls, I think. Should we get the vehicle? All you have to do is talk to this pirate man here. Ask him what's wrong and he'll lie to you about his car. Right, and what he wants you to do, and I've done this in previous vids, so we're going to do it quickly now, is look for the chap in the fancy car. He's usually around here somewhere. Tap by roller rat. Oh, you will get used to reading that message. Go away. Come on, man in your fancy car. No? Alright, we'll check on you when we've found a mini-ball. quickest way I know to the mini balls is to head up and over these hills over here. Tap my roller at. You're going to be reading that pretty much till you get out of backyard type areas. Just close that down. And they may give up following us at this point, if we're lucky. I hate roller rats, and anyone who's played the game from earlier days will definitely know why. Bulls, yeah, should be a couple up here. Don't attack the leets, there's a follow-on mission for them. Besides, some of these are quite high level. In fact, I think the bulls are probably quite high a level as well. So we may end up bravely running away. Elite King, don't need him just now. And we got a guy, Jackbot. Level 14 engineer. Angry Minibolt. So we can bring it down before it gets to us. Yeah, that's one advantage of range damage. Please have plates. I bet it doesn't. Leather hide. No, we want plates. I'll leave the leather hide. Pretty sure it's these guys that drop them. Oh yeah, I'm pressing reload because I've just used burst and whatnot and don't really need to. Angry Minibull. Don't think that'll hit us, it being green. But you never know. No, and ding. Nothing off that guy. Okay, keep your eye on the map. You can see there's one dead ahead. You want to make sure there's not any particularly close to him. Well, he's quite high level. Maybe throw that up as well. Oh, that wasn't as difficult as I thought it was going to be, being honest with you. No, leather hide. And I'm almost sure it's these guys that drop it. Watch me be completely wrong and not having watched my own video. But I know I did do this before. Oh, there you go. See, another mini ball behind me. Now I'm in trouble. Ish. Well, not really. Aha, there we go. Bone plates. So bone plates with that gives us one of these. Now I need to remove my weapon. So just to recap. There you go. It does 1.5 to 12 or 3 to 24. Now if I apply this to it, dun dun dun, yep, it now does, as you can see there, 4 to 18, so it's all upgraded a bit, and it's still a very fast weapon. Right, so that's us done with mini bulls, really, and, oh, attack my mini bull, one spawned right behind me, can I get him from here? Yes, I can, and I'm doing a lot more. Now, when you hit burst, I think you can hit with a maximum of 6 bullets, is it? Might even be 3. But you can see there, the burst damage, 114 points of damage. And I don't think we even got one regular shot off. Oh, yes, we did. There we go, 37. Now, his resistance, that mini bull's resistance to poison damage, will be a lot lower than it would have been to projectile, which is what that ring was improving, so I'm getting rid of it. I'm going to replace it with that, and I need to buy some boots. But while I'm running, I can do useful things, like upgrade this armor. And my nano hood. Ah, there's our guy in the truck. I'm going to ignore that thing for a minute and just... Do we right click? Yeah. And now I kill the poor sod. Yeah. Didn't say it was a nice mission. I just said it was a mission. Kill the roller rat. You got anything interesting? I'm thinking no. I'm thinking nothing at all. Right, so now we killed him. Fancy car, but we can't keep it, unfortunately. No, we can't. So what was I doing? Gloves, wasn't I? Are these now 9? Put those on there. All become clear with this armor very shortly. Like I say, I've already done the walkthrough on how to upgrade it to the clan or sided armor, and we're definitely going clan. Just because. Yeah. Now, remarkably, no one seems to mind that you just smack someone's car with a sledgehammer, pull them out of it, and kill them. It's like it's Grand Theft Auto. Right, we have your vehicle. And so we give him that, and he unfortunately wants his crowbar back. So we give him both, and he gives us a nano. Now the nano gives you this. Modify run speed 500. So we can upload that, but if we use it, you get this. Yeah, turns out it wasn't his vehicle. Supposedly he's adding 500 run speed, however. Although it says that here, kind of exploring, I've suddenly got 168, but I don't think I have really, have I? No. So we're going to tap a couple of these, save that. Oh, I've got a whole level worth to play with, so we'll do that. I don't think it's actually adding that much. It is quicker, but 500 quicker? No. Someone cast Grid Space Freedom on us, or an equivalent run buff to 500, then... no, I don't think so. Trade and repair. 87. There you go. It's not like he's died forever anyway. It's not. He's only a bit dead. All right, so we'll jump out of that. All right, which should mean we can now upload the long hot. So I've got... oh, I don't want that one though. So I've got short hot, long hot on the bar. And you see how much it's filled up already. Now, route. Psycho, what is it? Sensory improvement 48. Right, okay, so Lancaster in sensory improvement. We'll go to 50 because I like round numbers. Right, so if we do that. Right, now that, when it lands on someone or a bunch of mobs, will reduce their speed. If they're already moving, it will snare them. If they're stood still, they'll stay stood still. Although when you start shooting at them, you will sort of break it. Now then, main quest. Go and hack us something. Now if you remember, we were over here before when we first started out, and yep, we're right by the room. So now we just need to nip in here. Ship manifest terminal. Right click. Access shipping manifest. Apply hacker tool. To do it, pick it up and put it in there. Say okay. Say goodbye. Try that again. Did I give it the wrong thing? Access over there. Hack technical library. It's not the hacker tool. Oh, hacker tool. Hacker tool. Right, okay. Hopefully that's the right one. Apply the hacker tool. Drop that in there. Click OK. Reroute shipping report data. We had to do some terrible things to survive in here. Honest. Yeah, leaving salve. If you remember, we picked up an instruction disc from it before. But we also got it in that pack. So now I've done that. If you look at that nano. Now, these used to last about 20 minutes. They now last 4 hours. 4 hours! And hit you 1,414 times for that much. Which basically means you've got a hot running for 4 hours, which seems a bit unfair on keepers, but there we are. There's Do Now Stack, which is quite good. So, return to Vernon Godfrey. We're all souped up now. We've got better armour. Oh, and I need to get boots, don't I? Let's grab the boots. Alright, there she is, Sarah Green. Hello, Sarah. May I buy some boots? I bought the wrong ones. Sundance, no. Newcomers, yes. Goodbye. Right, okay, so I can now click these up. Eventually. See how they keep zigzagging now. What you don't want is a space up here and a space all the way down there, because it will, as you saw earlier, jump between. So where are we on? They're on 10. Now pop them on. Ace. Right. So now, return to Vernon. And he's not a very friendly chap, even though we've just done this job for him. I've returned, and what does he want? You should have an ID card of some fashion, so we give him the ID card, and you see it says ID on it in tiny little letters. Say okay, there we go, and he's done anything else. Say great, anything else, and he just basically utterly ignores you. Right, so that's done. Talk to Dr. Mason, and basically he wants you to make implant, a leg implant, in sequence. So there he is, nanomage, a fat nanomage. I heard you might be able to help me. I'll come back when I'm done. So he gives you this. And this does trip people up. You have to assemble it in the order described in the mission. So it says, buy a basic leg implant. So implants, basic. And we want leg. They've changed these, so they do... Yeah, basic left arm looks more like leg than leg used to. Is that leg? Basic leg arm, 10. Don't need a 10. We'll do a 5. We say, okay, then buy a agility cluster shiny. Cluster's faded, cluster's bright, cluster's shiny. And we want agility. Now, if we go to list mode, this gets easier. Yeah, see what I mean? It's alphabetical. Agility, leg, to quality 5, that'll go straight in. So we say, okay. Now, it wants us to combine them. If you press Shift T, you can do it this way. You can do it in your inventory, of course, but... You make the leg the target and the cluster there, it will tell you you need 22 skill in nano programming. Well, we've got a buff for that. So we go to Psi, target ourselves, cast this. We should have enough to do it now. And we do, without spending any extra IP. Now, you can buy ready-mades. There we go. So you look, you think, oh, I've done it. No. For some reason, you have to go back and click it again. Now buy a bright stamina. Well, here's bright. We want stamina. She'll be somewhere near the bottom. Okay, and combine them. And then a faded agility. Thankfully, there you go. Oh, hang on. I read that wrong. Max health. Yes, that would have been funny. Max health, quality 5. Okay, and... Da-da-da. He'll now ask us to put it in, I think. Dr. Mason has provided you with a recipe for a leg implant. Once it's been completed, allow him to inspect it. So you don't put it in straight away. Finish the implant. Give it over. He gives it straight back. And he says, use the stationary clinic in there. I wish they did look like that on the mainland, but they don't. Now, it does that and it gives you this buff. Stationary clinic effect. Clinic effect. Clinic effect? What's that? It gives you 100 in treatment, but makes it possible to just right-click that into place. So we've done that bit. Now it says, talk to Dr. Mason, and also it tells you what he's going to need, which is quite helpful. And it's the bits we've already got. I've done that, and I've got the other items. So we give him one of them, and one of them. And there we go. We've got our ID card. That will get us out of the building. If you... think of this as a building. So yeah, if you present that to the guard at the way out, I think that works. Or no, we need to talk to Laura Lee. Ooh, and the camera's gone a bit mad. Press number 5 on your keypad to reset. Right, Laura Lee, and a bit of XP spending, bit of IP. Already outgrowing this weapon. Range specials, burst, nano and casting. We'll leave them just for now, although I know it's going to be Matamet and Biomet for a better hot. Exploring, always going to want more run speed, combat and healing. Do both because on the other things I'm going to do pretty quickly is upgrade those. Training pair, awesome. Is grab the sided armor, which again, I've also got in another quest. And I think for our first episode of Froob Friendliness, we're not doing bad. So we'll get this finished. Laura Lee, the bartender. I was able to tell me you might give me a hand. No, it's okay. Blah, 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 blah. I'll help you. And it's about... and then do remember to ask this question. Is there anything about... anything in particular I should know about Lolly? And it's that she likes cookies. Guess where you get the cookies? Yes, you guessed it. You buy them here. I think it's got a blue name as well. There we go. Tasty peanut butter cookie. So, okay. This trips people up no end. I put a guide for how to do this, and I'll put the link over there. And I'll show you it again. Yes, I will. So we're heading to where Laura Lee the Leet, or Lolly the Leet, will be for Laura Lee. Okay, if someone wants to go and fetch my tongue from wherever it just fell out trying to say that, you go ahead. All right, most of the mobs here won't attack you. You've got desert reeds, etc. The one we want's got a blue name. You see little X on the map there? It's where it thinks she is. Now, they're not always here. They can despawn, so to speak, and sometimes they're way down here. Now, there used to be a log that it would get stuck on all the way down here. But I think they removed the log to try and fix that. So I'm coming down to have a look. Ah, there she is. Laura the Leet, right click. So it's like you've opened coming in. And basically, please get into the cage. Give you a cookie. Quietly pick up bird. Hopefully you can see this. She's vanished. And she's there. And you just pop the bird in the cage. Now, Gnarl the Roller. Die. Hopefully we can survive that. Or is this guy going to join in? Now, that's my first fixer dilemma. I'm going to get both of these guys. Or is he running off? He could be running off. Have a look. Saltworm. Now, there you go. Lolly's respawned. I think it might be coming for me. I'm not sure. Not sure what that's doing, actually. Anything good? Resolving self, we've already got. Mossy rock. That's not bad. Soulfire. If you make an Advi, grab this. They're actually useful, especially for Froob melee Advis. Saltworm just generally being odd. Let's give it some... Oh dear, what level is it? 13. No, we can handle that. Even if I have to kite it, I'm going to fight it. Just for the XP. This doesn't seem terribly hard. I've only got one hot running, so let's get the other one on the go. That. Plus a bit of first aid. We should be alright. Yeah, I think we can survive this if we're a bit lucky. Now, I've got the root, so let's just... It countered, so that didn't land. Let's try again. Got it. So we should be able to actually move ourselves out of its damage range. Or maybe not. No, it's broken it already. No. Not working. So we're definitely going to need this first aid. Yeah, I think we can get this guy. Let's try another snare. Nope. Don't want to spend too much nano pool. Okay, that should be enough. Gotta be careful, it's an AoE. We're gonna pick up damage from a bunch of other mobs we've just angered. I forgot about that, actually. Oh dear. It's going to be our first fixer proper death. Running away. But you see, we are regaining health. So we've got basing each. I've got both hots running, so as long as I can maintain a fair distance between us, should recover enough health to run back. Now, it's whether he's still in the fight. He thinks he is. Go for that and go full death. See if we can just survive him a bit longer. Okay, we beat him. And vanished corpse. We can't lose. It's probably in the ground somewhere, or it's bounced somewhere else. So never mind. Right, let's get back with the bird. Because you literally can, as a fixer at least, outrun these guys. Especially if you are being chased. Don't forget full death. Right, all of my 220s pretty much stay at full defense all the time now. Right, I think we'll hand this in. And I think that'll do for the first through walkthrough proper. So that's the entire sort of main quest line in here, with a couple of the side quests thrown in for good measure. Right. Lorelei the bartender, I have your lolly the leet. Alright, so we hand her that and our ID. Now it should be completed. Yes, it is. It's like a driving license. Thank you. And goodbye. Right, so we've not done bad. So there you go, 1 hour in here, we've walked away, we've got that. Now, last thing I want to do is actually upgrade the armour. So before we go, we'll do that. What are you doing here? I agree with you, Omnitech needs to play. Play? Pay. We say goodbye, and it just sends us straight over to talk to someone. So if we press B, it's not very useful, because it doesn't zoom in all that far in here. But if we look on here, we can see we need to talk to some big chap over in this corner. And once again, has a blue name. So we talk to him. If you know you're going to go clan anyway, and I would, we just say yes. And he will tell you more about the clans, or you can just join anyway. Or you can join the big corporate baddies, who for some reason don't realise they're the bad guys. Yes, corporation trying to run a planet and not letting people do anything is slightly evil. No, apparently the clans are the dirty rebels. I'll never figure out how people think that. But yeah, next time a corporation's bulldozing your home, let me know. Right, so he's given us this, which is an unknown device, but it's not. It's a thing we use on a vehicle. So basically, we're doing someone's vehicle over. Officer Milne's vehicle. I can't remember if you pick it up and click. Apparently, yeah, we do. I think we better run away. Are you repairing the car or what? Not really. We don't have to kill this guy, by the way. I just want to. I'm trying to refill my nano. It's going very slowly. Wonder how the snare... Oh, actually, no. I'm a bit close to everything else to use that. See, don't forget, this first one you get is an AOE. I'm not sure exactly how far 20 meters is in here, but far enough. And at full death, that guy didn't really have much chance of hitting us. Any loot? I don't think he ever dropped any loot. Nope. Right, so we've done that. We run back, and the guy will give us a item that we click so we can be fully clan, which of course we're going to do. You know it. Besides, I know my way around the clan side of things a lot better than I do the Omni ones. I do know a little bit around the Omni ones, but it's like you have to go to Rome to get dailies. It's like Rome is just like Lagorama, or you crash. So yeah, they should move that, really. They should put that somewhere better, because there's like absolutely no one in that town otherwise. Redrickton, I've done my thing. I did just as you told me. So we get the token board there, but we're going to use this first. You want to use it? Yes, now I'm clan. And then click on this neck item. It does nothing at the moment because we haven't got any tokens until we click this. There we go. Take it off. Re-click. Side tokens collected. 1. Only 1,000 to go before it starts getting really useful. Goodbye. Now we get the 2 pads, and if you click them, they change. So we don't need the nano cost. Should we go off or death? We click one more time. Yeah, we get add all death. So I'm going to replace the sense sensor, which I don't feel like I need. And this one, once again, all off or all death. We'll go all death. We're fixers. It's all about the death. Now we've done that, and we've got nearly 30k. We can certainly get a lot more than that in here. Clan equipment vendor will now trade with us. Armor upgrades. I've got some newcomer's armor. How do I upgrade it? She will tell you. And like I say, I've already done it before. Right. And so we want clan's badge. And we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's just check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We need 6 of these. Say okay. They were cheap enough. And start with the boots. Take them off. Now, just to show you before I get cracking, I'm going to take this back thing off. Now, that's what the newcomer's armor looks like. Bit rubbish, but at least it's not the junk you're picking up on the floor with holes in the backside. Now, let's take this one off and upgrade that. And then let's upgrade both arms. Pants, maybe? And lastly, we'll do the gloves. And then we can just click them all because we did level. Bit laggy. Chest armor. There we go. Now we actually look a bit less noob. I mean, to me, a veteran looks totally noob, but compared to what you looked like before, a little less so. So yeah, we've done that. You can buy some sunglasses off them, but I don't think we want to. And I could stay in here a bit longer and roll alts to go and grab that credit card and give me the money. And I might do that, actually. Not sure that's entirely fair play or even a bit naughty, but it's certainly something we could do. But anyway, for the next one, I'll be stepping outside. And one thing I've always liked about this place is when you step outside, the first thing that you see, other than noob guilds trying to grab people, is someone to give you a quest. Okay, folks, bye for now.